Don't we need to be in dialogue with China? It's likely to be the biggest economy in the world at some point.
Well, we do, but I think rather than trying to do this individually, we ought to be doing this collectively, because China has a history of being able to frankly bully other countries on a bilateral basis, but has much more, if you like, respect and, you know, sort of responds in a better way when approached collectively by a group of countries instead. And the great fear is that we're all going individually, one by one, to China, you know, then not being able to enforce any sort of values-based issues and then giving them whatever they want on the economy. And as a result, it's win-win for them, really.
So a softly, softly approach, not the best.
No, but as I say, it's collective action, I think, that's the key to how you deal with China going forwards. Individually, they will pick us off one by one. But collectively, we do have the opportunity and ability to make a difference and to actually persuade the Chinese to change track. Because it's only by, if you like, the power of collectivity here that we're going to be able to actually enforce any kind of change. Because there's a Communist Party in charge of China. They have their own objectives. They're not going to listen to us unless, essentially, we force them to listen to us.
And you generally don't think that they're going to listen to the UK, one of the G7, arguably one of the most influential countries in the world?
No, because did they listen to us over Hong Kong, where they even signed a treaty with us? No, they completely rode roughshod over it. And as a result, Hong Kong was taken, the treaty was kind of pushed to one side, and the freedoms of Hong Kong have lost. And don't forget, that was a treaty we actually signed with them. So it seems unlikely they're going to listen to us on our own if they weren't even prepared to acknowledge and give way to a treaty that they'd signed with us.